Hi students, here is your second module, Collection and Transportation of Waste. In this session, we will discuss about different methods of collection and transportation facilities. So let's move into details. First, what is collection? That is, it is transferring of waste from an initial point to final disposing site. It is important to have a proper collection because then only we can have clean surroundings, better health, and it will also help to return waste to useful resources. Different methods can be employed, that is house-to-house collection, community bins, curbside pickup and self-deliver. The choice of the method is dependent on the situation and the location. And the whole collection and transportation system is a chain of linked stages which involves different processes like on-site storage, primary collection, secondary collection, transfer stations and disposing site. It starts with on-site storage, that is when a person puts the waste in a container. There can be different type of containers as you can see here. The choice of the containers is dependent on location and situation. That a single family requires only small container which can be handled manually. And the industries and the institutions require large containers which needs mechanical handling. So a good container, in both cases a good container is must, because containers plays an important role in the efficiency of this process. So how we can decide whether it is good or not? It should satisfy some criteria, like it should be of low cost, appropriate size, strong, durable, corrosion resistant and recyclable. And it should not have rough surfaces and sharp edges, and should be always covered and provided with wheels. So we should consider these properties while selecting a container. After this, the next step is collection, and it can be primary collection and secondary collection. Primary collection involves collection of waste from the initial point to the disposal site or transfer station, and secondary collection involves transfer of the waste from the transfer station to disposing site. And what is transfer station and why it is needed, we'll tell you later. In both cases, whether it is primary or secondary, transportation facilities are required, that is vehicles are needed for these process. Here you can see the vehicles used for primary collection: hand cart, cycle cart, wheelbarrow, donkey cart and tractor. The choice of the vehicle is also dependent on the situation and location, and also the amount of waste to be transported. Here is a list of vehicles used for secondary collection: flatbed crane truck, enclosed light truck, truck fitted with bin lifter and compactors. These are sometimes used for the primary collection purposes also. And there are two different types of collection strategies. It is based on the containers that we use. One is hauled container system or drop off box. Another is stationary container system. In hauled container system, the container is of moving type. That is, container is transported to the disposing site from the storage site, and once they are emptied, they are returned back to the storage site. But in the case of stationary container system, it is of it is not moving type. In this case, the waste are directly transferred from the container to the vehicle at storage site, and the vehicles will dispose these waste to disposing site. So this is what occurs in these two container system. So whether it is of any type, the collection should starts with segregation, that is placing waste in separate containers. So differently colored bins can be used for this purpose. Example, green colored bins are normally used for putting biodegradable waste like kitchen waste, and it is necessary to practice segregation all the time because it helps the collection process easier, and also the collecting persons can differentiate and they can take necessary precautions while handling with toxic substances. So the collecting persons are doing a great job by protecting us from health hazards that may cause by the waste, right? So it is necessary to protect themselves. So they should wear gloves, masks, long sleeve shirts, pants and shoes. So in any system, well planning is required. So a well planned collection and transfer can lead to significant reductions in overall cost of waste management also. It can be done by identifying pickup points, grouping these pickup points to a single collection round, and planning the route of each collection round. And the routing can be done by micro routing or macro routing. In micro routing, the routing of vehicle within assigned collection zone, and in macro routing, large scale routing to the disposal site. Compared to macro routing, micro routing are difficult to design and execute. Next, I will make you familiar with some terms that we normally use in transfer and collection processes. One is pickup. It refers to the time spent driving to the next container after emptying the first container, and the time required to reach the disposal site are known as hold, and the time spent at this disposal site are known as at site. And normally we spend some times on non-productive activities, and that times are termed as off-site. So next is, what's the need of a transfer station? Transfer station you have heard about in primary collection and secondary collection. So what is its need? Because mainly the vehicles used for primary collection purposes cannot travel a long distance, so the waste needs to be taken off from them to the secondary collection vehicle. So these are done at transfer station, and sometimes these stations are used for extracting the recyclable materials from the mixed waste. There are two type of transfer station: mechanically loaded and simple transfer station. And transferring can be direct discharge type, storage discharge type, or combined direct and storage discharge type. So these are the mechanism involved in collection and transport processes. And there are some important points to consider, that are: regular collection is necessary to avoid problems of storage, and also vehicles which are used for transportation should be fully covered. If it's not covered, it will cause foul odors, eyesores, and also will lead to scattering of waste materials in the street. And another thing is, the route to the final destination should be direct as possible. That is, the final destination site means disposing site. So this disposal sites should be 30 meters from water sources to prevent the water pollution, and also 500 meters from any residential areas. So till now I have discussed about common methods. There are recent technology which are not fully established everywhere. Some of the examples are Metron Typhon. It's a waste sorting system with use of underground pipes. It's like a giant vacuum cleaner. And another one is a pneumatic refuse collection system, which is used for rapid transportation of waste with the help of pneumatic tubes located underground. So whatever the system we use, effective waste management needs cooperation from both local people and authorities. So always try to keep your surroundings clean and collect all your waste in a systematic way, so it will be easier for you to remove it. Thank you so much.